Hey everybody, it's Kyle. Thank you guys for checking out these videos that we're going to try and post from time to time on how to play some of the guitar tracks for the Days of Love, which I hope you've had a chance to check out by the time you're watching these. So the first thing that I wanted to do is just kind of talk a little bit about the influence as far as recording the record, how we wanted to try and go about recording the guitar tracks. And basically, the idea was, compared to previous records, we wanted to make the guitar tracks fewer. We wanted to do fewer of them so they could be more intentional and ultimately louder. Instead of having like 8 parts trying to do one thing, or instead of trying to record a verse and then stop and then get a sound and come up with a part and record the chorus and then the bridge and so on. We really try to be intentional about making the parts fit for the entire length of the song. And instead of doing like 8 parts, like I said, I try and keep it down to 2 or 3. I don't think any of the tracks on the album have more than 4, maybe 5 guitar parts total. So that was the idea there, and the idea for me as a guitar player was also to kind of keep the effects more at a minimum than I usually do. Instead of kind of letting delays or effects be a crutch, kind of, which they can be pretty easily, I was really made a point to try and keep the effects just to fit the part and keep them at a minimum and make the part be the main thing. So guitar-wise on this record, this is actually a new guitar that I just got. This is a 1973 Gibson ES-335. I actually didn't use this on the record because I just got it, but I did use... I'll be using this on these videos, where on the record I actually used a 72 Tele Deluxe that a friend let us borrow. So on these videos, this will be taking the place of that, and live it'll be taking the place of that as well. Also on the record, I used my Gibson Les Paul, which I've used for a while now. This is a Gibson Les Paul Classic. I used this on a few parts on the record, not very many, probably under 5. I used this Strat, which is called the Lone Star Strat. They don't actually make anymore, that has a humbucker here in the bridge. I used that for very few parts. And then I also used for quite a bit of the record this Tele Thin Line that I've been playing for a while. So those are the guitars that I use. I tracked the entire record on 2 amps, my Fender DeVille 410 that I've had for a long time, and also a Bogner Shiva with 112 that I ran the... It was the hotter amp. It was kind of the more distorted amp. And I used those two, and then I picked either, in post-production, I picked one or the other amp to use, or I blended them to get a sound. So between those, I got pretty much all the sounds I needed. And take a look at my pedal board down here real quick, which is very similar to kind of what I've used in the past. I tend to try and let the parts in my playing be... more important than kind of what effects I'm using. Like I said, instead of trying to let the delays be a crutch or whatever. So I'll just kind of go through it real quick and show you what we got. And I'll reference these pedals in the rest of the videos that I do. And so when I say, you know, I'm using this pedal here, you know what I'm talking about. So from the top, this is just an Ernie Ball volume pedal that I'll use, especially doing swells and stuff like that. Next is a Dunlop Crybaby. Wah, which I don't actually even know if I use on this record at all. Next is a Boss Blues Driver, which is my main overdrive. That for the record, I set the gain, this knob here, I set pretty low, and I would set the level really high, even higher than I have it now, usually 3/4 or even more, just to kind of let the parts be real clear. If you get too much distortion in there, they become a little bit muddy. Next is a Full Tone Fat Boost, which is just a gain boost that I would use for grittier parts or for kind of solos that would just need a little bit of a volume boost. After that is a Boss Flanger and an MXR Phase 90, just for kind of some phasing effects. After that's a Boss Tremolo that I mainly use at the end of a song, kind of that last big chord that we might hit. I'll just pop it on and kind of let it do a tremolo tail at the end there. Next is a Line 6 Verbzilla, which is a fairly new pedal for me that I use. It's a reverb pedal, but I mainly use it for a couple of sounds, including a kind of a room reverb and a chamber reverb. And it's also got a great setting called Octo, which is an octave thing. Plays it up an octave, and it really sounds like strings. You can kind of do some fake string sounds with that. After that is my main delay, this Boss DD5 that has a tap tempo pedal that I can use as well. And I use that mainly for quarter note delays and also dotted eighth delays as well. After that is another reverb. This is the Electro Harmonix Holy Grail. And it is mainly used for two different settings. The second setting is called Hall, and I'll run it pretty hot, even about three quarters or so, for a really, really affected reverb sound, as if you're miking it from the next room. And I'll also use it for the third setting. It's called Flurb, which is kind of a real floaty, atmospheric sound, and I'll also run that pretty hot on there as well. After the Holy Grail is a Boss EQ that I use pretty much solely to do like an AM radio guitar sound, kind of a bad guitar sound on purpose. And every now and again I'll use it as a gain boost a little bit if I need to. After that is my secondary delay, the Line 6 DL4, which I currently have programmed to do the three programs I have in here. The first are just a regular digital delay. Second is what's called a low resolution delay, which is a great sound on here. It's kind of a tape echo, where each delay sounds worse in quality than the one before it. And then the third one that I have set is a reverse delay, so when I play something it'll delay it but then play it in reverse, which I use especially on these broken hearts as a main part of the guitar part, so I'll show you that. This is the tap tempo. And I also use it to loop some stuff on there, if live, especially if I'm playing more than one part. And then last is just a regular old tuner there. So that's the gear that I use on the record, and now I'll take you through the parts of the songs.